And we bring you the war on I-4 between these two Florida rivals. Let's head down to the coin toss now. And it's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste and zero calories. Enjoy everything. Is lined up and just about ready to send this one off as we're ready to get this game underway. He's to the 20. Tackle made at the 21. So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. About the 33-yard line.
Besides going deep on the fade, the slant route is probably the most commonly run route against man coverage. If the receiver gets a good inside release, it'll be a new set of downs every time.
From their own 33-yard line, first down.
Red two.
Tackle made at the 46.
When you're running the ball for big chunks of yards like that, you've got something working.
They move the sticks after another first down.
Impressive drive by this offense so far. I really like what they're doing by keeping this defense on their heels and moving the ball downfield.
First and 10, ball on the 43-yard line. Play action, defense coming, and down he goes, around the 24-yard line.
Man, did he ever sell the run? The defense took the bait, and that hesitation was enough to give the receiver room to make the catch.
First and 10, ball on the 24-yard line. Tack on any yardage.
That'll bring up second and 3.
Here we go.
Scrambling around. Catches it, gets out of bounds. Akins picks up about 5 yards on that hookup.
And that's just great execution on that short pass play.
And the quarterback didn't waste any time getting rid of that one. He took the snap and he threw it right out there from the 12-yard line. First down.
Red 2, 3, 15.
He's scrambling. Quick throw, tight end, touchdown.
This team has so many potent weapons. It's tough to try to single out just one of them to stop.
They'll go for 2 in this situation. So the referee initially calls it a catch, but we'll get a second look at it here and determine if he was in bounds when he hauled it in.
And that play happened so fast that it was very tough to tell if he was able to get a foot down or not.
After review of the play, the ruling on the field stands.
So after some discussion, the call on the field stands. Central Florida with a 6-point lead. And he adds the extra point. So a 7-play, 78-yard drive, and they put up 7 points.
You know, Brad, a lot of times you have to watch practice and watch a 7-on-7 drill to not see the ball touch the ground. This time they went the entire length of the field. The ball never touched the ground. Great execution by the quarterback and the receiver.
And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The quarterback leads the team out on the field for the first drive. And they get nice yardage on that run.
That's a gain of 5 on the play. That brings up 2nd and 5.
Tosses across the middle to his tight end, and he's taken down.
At about the 37-yard line.
Brings him down, 37-yard line. That makes it 1st and 10.
Oklahoma!
Takes it up the middle for a nice run. At midfield, and he's tackled around the 44-yard line.
Johnson on the tackle at the 44-yard line. First down.
They'll spread the field with 5 wide. He catches another. He's at the 20. Tackle around the 15-yard line.
Once this guy gets into the secondary, he can be a real problem to bring down. He can shake off a lot of tacklers who are smaller than he is.
He scrambled, and they got him. Great play by the defense.
Well, that time they came with the blitz, and the linebacker was able to get free and come away with the sack.
They come up to the line here. It's 2nd down and 14 after the sack. He pitches it. The 5. He steps out of bounds, and now it's going to be 1st and goal.
16 on the play. That makes it 1st and goal.
Watch two. You ain't got nothing.
We're going to scramble down. He can't get away from the pressure.
Loss of 7 yards on the play. That brings up 2nd and goal.
Somebody hit the upset alert button, because this one looks like it just might be heading in that direction. 7-0, UCF. From the 10-yard line, 2nd down. Up the middle for a nice game.
Called a gain of 6 yards. That makes it 3rd and goal.
They come out on an empty backfield. Gets rid of it.
Good job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
This isn't much more than an extra point. The kick is up, and he got it.
And you got to think they're pretty happy with holding him to a field goal right there.
Hernandez is lined up to kick this one off. Excellent kick. He's to the 10. He's to the 20. Tackle at the 20-yard line. There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes. Central Florida is up 4. Room around the corner. He's pushed out of bounds around the 27-yard line.
2nd and 2.
Black five.
Great pressure on the quarterback, forced that incompletion.
Boy, they really pounded him on that throw.
That'll bring up 3rd and 2.
So it's 3rd down, and they've got about 2 yards to go.
Down at the 36. That's good enough for another UCF. First down.
Four down.
down
at about the 45.
Another run, and he's going to be brought down in the backfield.
Third down.
And two.
He's on the run. Smith was the intended target. That's going to bring up fourth down.
The defense held their ground on that play. The quarterback just wasn't able to find any open receivers.
It looks like they're going to go after this punt. Signals for a fair catch. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Caught out in the open. He's taken down
at about the 29-yard line.
That's a gain of 14 yards on the play. That makes it first and 10.
Choose the mic.
And he's hit immediately. So they pick up quite a few yards on that play, Kirk.
Well, that was an excellent route, and he did a great job of holding on to the football.
It's second down, and they're about the length of the football from the first down marker. Steps out of bounds at the 41-yard line. So they gain 3 yards on the play and pick up the first down.
Since he only needed a few yards, the little dump off pass worked to perfection.
They make the stop around the 36-yard line.
Hughes with the tackle at the 36-yard line.
Come on.
First down.
Mike, he's coming. He's coming. Check in. Yeah. Check, 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 check. Oklahoma. Hey. Hold
there. He's hit and taken down.
Gain of 12 yards. That makes it first and 10.
USF trying to go up by 3. They'll kick the extra point, and he tacks on the extra point. A 6-play 84-yard drive, and they get it in for 7.
An amazing drive for this offense. Outstanding execution. If you're the defense, you've got to do something to try to change things up to get this quarterback out of sync.
So our score, 10-7. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He'll take it from the 2. He's tackled at the 24-yard line.
Kickoff returns 22 yards.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Caught, enough for the first down. And he's tackled right away.
First down.
From their own 36-yard line, it's first down. Got a man, watch out here. He's tackled at the 39.
Wilkins makes the tackle at the 39-yard line. That'll make it second to 7.
Dancer, dancer. Hey, kill, kill, kill!
Fires to the wideout, first down. Tackle made around the 45-yard line.
That'll move the chains for another UCF. First down.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 45-yard line.
Kill, kill.
Now he tries to buy some time. The cavalry's coming. He airs it out. Doesn't get there.
You don't think these guys get aggressive when it counts? Terrific hit to prevent the score.
It's second and 10.
Man left, man left. Four down.
He's going to try and scramble. He's going to go for the home run. Almost intercepted.
How did he drop that? The defender did everything that he needs to do. He read the play perfectly. He stepped up, and what does he do? He drops the interception. Boy, the offense caught a break there.
Let's see if a quarterback heaves it up there and one of his guys can come down with it. He's rolling right. He heaves it deep. Missed him. We've still got a half of football remaining. The Bulls with a three-point lead. All right, Reese and David, thanks, guys. Second half action just about ready to start here. Sends it sailing downfield. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. So we're just about ready to return to action. South Florida has a three-point lead. Just gets rid of it.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
Makes the catch and look out. Finds his man. First down.
Gain of 22 on the play. First down.
As they're in the shotgun. Fires out to his receiver, and down he goes at about the 21.
Kneeled on the tackle at the 21-yard line. That makes it first and 10.
Five wide. Now he's scrambling. Slides down to the ground. South Florida holds a field goal lead. And he's level at the 22-yard line. From the 22-yard line, third down. Got his back, but he can't hang on. Kicks away, and it's good. They line up to kick this one away. Nice kick, plenty of distance. He's to the 20. They'll bring him down at the 27. The Bulls continue to get it done on the defensive side of the football, Kirk.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building this lead and almost determined here to protect it. Let's see if they can hold on here for the rest of the way.
This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. He's scrambling. Room around the corner. He has some room. He gets hit out of bounds. Around the 43-yard line. From their own 43-yard line. First down. Rifles it left. Makes the catch and gets out of bounds.
Dog 4, 3-15.
scrambling around. Throws it into coverage, and it's intercepted. Big opening. And that tackle very well could have saved the touchdown.
The quarterback should have thrown that one out of bounds. There was just no room to get it past that safety.
From the 20-yard line, first down. South Florida is up by six. He scrambles. They bring the quarterback down.
Coaches don't like it when their quarterback gets hit like that. Don't be surprised to see the old coach get on his lineman to protect the quarterback a little bit better.
It's second down, 12 to go. Ball on the 22-yard line. And he's stopped behind the line.
Excellent play here by the quarterback, making the proper reads and finding his playmaker for the score.
It was a pretty simple route, but they run it to perfection for the score. He splits the uprights with the extra point. With a three-play, 20-yard drive, and it results in a touchdown. So the score now, 20-7. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. And he got all of this one. Great kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Rolls to the right. Tackle at the 40-yard line.
Really, there's not much more the defense could do there. They had outstanding coverage. It was just good execution from the quarterback making the right throw and the receiver going up and making a catch.
Red two.
He chucks it downfield. That close to being intercepted.
Well, you want to do everything you can to keep the ball out of the hands of these receivers. So that was a really good effort.
From their own 40-yard line, second down. Stays in bounds and made a nice catch.
Nice throw to hit the out route against man coverage for a first down.
Makes it first and 10.
From the 45-yard line, it's first down. That's three down and one to go. The Bulls with a 13-point lead.
Larry. 43 on the mic. Heavy on the edges. Come on.
Passes it, and it's picked out of the sky.
Sanchez with the interception.
Get him!
I just don't think he saw the defender, and he threw the ball right at him. That's what happens when you focus on one guy. You get tunnel vision.
All right, we're just about set to start action here again in the fourth quarter. Just under three to go in regulation. Here he goes. Makes it out to about the 49.
First down.
From the 49-yard line, first down. He's tackled right around the 48-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 1 yard. That brings up second and nine.
Larry. Mike, Texas.
And they'll get him in the backfield. Third down, and they need to get it down to the 39.
Get that quarterback!
Blue 19! They'll bring him down at the 48-yard line.
Loss of 2 yards on the play.
Hernandez to punt. Fields the punt at the 13, and he's taken down at the 19-yard line. Their last drive ended with an interception. We're about to find out what the defense can do this time.
This quarterback can make good passes. He just needs to focus on not forcing the ball to his receivers.
He's taken down at the 43. Central Florida just took their first time out.
That's good enough for another UCF. First down.
First and 10. Ball on their own 43. And they'll try one last pass here to pad the stats, but that's about all they're going to get right here. He's on the run. And he is drilled at the 38. And so that's going to do it. Our final score in this one, 20-7, Bulls. So what are your final thoughts on this one, Kirk?
They've talked about the rivalry all week long, and for good reason. We saw the intensity down on the field every play, and it showed us why these teams love to hate each other. It'll be interesting to see how this game carries over to the next time they play.
That's going to do it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying goodbye.